Hello there. In this quick tip video, we're going to take a look at the different types of record monitoring in Cubase. Now, record monitoring is the little button that allows us to hear what we're recording over the top of the rest of the track. And it's a pretty important function if you're recording audio into a project in Cubase. Just to clarify, the record monitor button is that orange speaker button which you can see on the tracklist, and you can activate and deactivate it with your mouse. Activating that monitor button will mean that we can hear the audio that's coming into Cubase, and we can hear the audio which is coming into Cubase via the audio connection. So right here, you can see one of my input buses is set to my audio interface input number 4, and I can name that if I want. So my audio is being routed through the 4th input on my audio interface, and then it's coming into this track right here. So I can see that it's coming into this track because of my inputs over here on the left hand side. I've got electric guitar specified, which is this input bus. Now, if we go down to the mix console here, you can see these 4 red faders here. Now, they're my inputs. So if I play my guitar, you can see that it's going to start metering as soon as I start playing, but it's not metering up on the track list and I can't hear it. To hear it, I need to turn on the monitor button, and that's the orange button, which I can activate independently of the record enable button. Now I can hear that guitar playing, which is pretty handy. Being able to hear it playing means that I can start to prepare and practice and rehearse exactly what I think I'm going to play whilst I'm recording. So now it's a matter of selecting the area where you want to record, making sure you've got the right channel selected. In this case, it's the electric guitar, this channel right here. Now I just need to hit the record enable button and Cubase knows exactly which channel I'm recording on, and I can start to play over the top of my track and I can hear what I'm playing, which is really useful. We can actually define how we want this record monitor button to behave inside of Cubase, and we do that up in the system preferences. On the left-hand side, select VST, and on the right-hand side, you can see all of the VST preferences, including the auto monitoring drop-down menu. We can change this to manual. Now, manual is an excellent setting if you have a third party or external controller with a button that you can use to activate the monitor button. Now, this is great because it's sitting right in front of you, and when you want to record on a track or a number of tracks, you just select record enable and the monitor button, and straight away you can hear what's coming through. Not so great if you've got to use your mouse to enable the monitor button or disable it every time you're recording or you want to monitor or you're playing back. So, not the greatest setting if you don't have an external controller. Back to our preferences, and the next one is whilst record enabled. Now, this means that we're going to be able to monitor our input every time a channel is record enabled. This, again, is an excellent setting if you've got an external controller, because it means every time you record enable a channel, whoever is playing through it can hear what they're playing. So it's pretty cool. If you want to disable the monitor, then you need to use your mouse or a third-party controller to disable the actual monitor button, which is sometimes pretty handy if you've got a player in the studio or even at home who's just playing constantly and not listening to anything else or not aware of any conversation that's going on around him or her. The only downside to this setting would be that a channel stays record enabled unless you disable it. So that means when you go to a playback, you're actually not going to hear what's been played on that channel because your monitor button is still set to monitor the instrument or the audio signal that's coming through it. So just remember that whilst in that record enable preference, you need to disable the monitor button to hear what's actually been recorded. So not that handy again if you're doing overdubs. Our next setting is whilst record is running, and that is pretty self-explanatory. That means that as soon as we hit record, we're going to be able to hear or monitor whatever's been recorded. So that is pretty handy for drop-ins. Let's say you're recording a section, you're listening to it, and you hit record, then the performer can hear what they're actually playing over the top of the recording. And that also means that when we hit play, play, we can hear what was recorded beforehand. Of course, we can still manually enable the monitor button so that the player can actually mess around and hear what they're playing or rehearse over the top of the recording. And that's the only real drawback with this setting, is just that you've got to activate the monitor button for the performer to hear what they're playing if Cubase is not recording. This next setting is pretty much my default if I don't have a control surface in front of me. Tape machine style is exactly the same as old school tape machines. It means that I'm always monitoring and I can hear what I'm playing unless I'm in playback. And then I can hear what was already recorded on the tape, or in this case, inside of Cubase. Once I start recording, Cubase will automatically activate the record monitor so I can hear what I'm recording. So for me, this fits the purpose of being able to record at home the best, because the moment I get an instrument in my hands, I can hear exactly what I'm playing and practicing and recording, unless it's playing back, in which case I'm hearing what I've already recorded. So there you have a very brief rundown of all of the different audio monitoring preferences inside of Cubase. And of course, as we've already covered, you can simply use your mouse to activate and deactivate the audio monitoring button. Hey, thanks for stopping by and taking the time to check out this video. Give us the thumbs up if you've learned something. And of course, subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel for plenty more videos just like this. I'll catch you there.